Welcome to how to use the fill in the blank widget. Let's just go ahead and grab a widget from the side and drop it on our page. It says double tap to edit it, so let's go ahead and do that. So this brings up an answer picker, and the way we submit an answer for this, and you can have more than one acceptable answer, an answer where the answer might be zero, we'll submit that. Or the answer might be one. Submit that. So we now indicate we have two answers. And if we close this out, we in fact see that two answers are listed here. And even over here, there's two answers. Which brings up a point that if we want to change the font and styling, we can actually accomplish that here. I'm going to caution you not to get too creative in your edit boxes for which fonts you use. But you may want to make the fonts a bit bigger and even change their colors to match the styling of your card. So now what we've done is we've changed the font and the size for answer type, but we're going to see an actual problem when we preview this. And that's that the font isn't the font we want. It's this weird substituted font. And that's because of a behavior where the fonts for a card are actually inherited from fonts that you've used elsewhere, you know, in text boxes. So if you want to use the Pacifico font here, then you have to use it somewhere else in your deck. Not necessarily on the same card, but somewhere else in your deck on an edit box. If you want to use the font Throw My Hands Up in the Air or Dancing Script, then you've got to put it someplace else on your card. And we've seen how we can change or supply more than one answer. Now this will be really useful also. Well, let's suppose you're asking, who's the first president of the United States of America? Well, you might say Washington is one acceptable answer, or George Washington might be another acceptable answer. But those would have to be case sensitive. So by checking this box now, if we go into our preview, if we type Washington, and here you can already see why having a weird font is not really a good idea in your edit box. If I type this with a lowercase w, it's incorrect. If I type it with a capital W, then it's correct. So let's go back. I want to revisit this concept of numeric again. So let's turn off case sensitive because it is not compatible with numeric. And let's clear these answers out. And let's say that we want a number, but we want the number to be 1,000. And this is for a math class, and that comma is really important. Then do not say it's numeric, because numeric, if we go ahead and submit this, and now we run this in the previewer, then if I type in 1 and I try to type the comma, it won't accept it. I'm trying. In fact, no letters except the letter E is allowed, because it wants numeric numbers. So let's see, 1e3 is 1,000. So that was acceptable. It wasn't the form that we were looking for. So if you have a very specific form that you're looking for, don't make your answer numeric. Keep it a string, and that will force the student. Now, let's suppose 1,000 is okay, and so is 1,000. You could code it like this and just list both answers, or you could save yourself some trouble and leave it as 1,000 and make it numeric and let the browser do that work for you and find the numeric equivalencies. Similarly, for your science and math classes, if your answer is supposed to be 0.01, and you need that the leading zero, don't make it numeric. Another example might be, suppose you want 1.00, because you want that precision. Again, don't make that numeric. Do not make that numeric, because 1.00 will numerically match 1, or 1.0, or 1 point. So those are when to use numeric and when not to. We've talked about case sensitive. We also talked about font styling. Kind of the last thing we need to cover in the answer picker is the open response and multi-line. So these typically go together, though they're not required. So if the answer is 1, spelled out like this, and you want it to be on multiple lines, let's talk about what's going to happen here. Let's go show this. So now, and actually I should just make this bigger. Oh, and I didn't submit my answer. So submit the answer 1. It's multiple line. When I preview this, when the student starts typing, when they hit the enter key, instead of submitting the button, it goes to this new line, and they can keep typing. Now if they submit this, that's obviously the wrong answer. If we change that and we type 1 and we submit that, that's the correct answer and it's good. Now, multi-line is most useful for open response. Open responses require human grading. Open response means that any answer that the student types will be accepted, any answer except a blank. And then here what you want to do is list model answers. So you're looking for something very specific in your model answer, you could type it here and say something to the grader, such as must mention condensation or vapor point of water. You submit this, and this will then be cues to the grader. Now, when we run this, the student can type anything that they want, such as water when it falls from the sky is called precipitation. That's acceptable for the student. They can type anything they want. If they accidentally hit the enter key, it doesn't auto submit. They hit the submit button, their answer has been submitted, and then it will show up later for the teacher to grade it. I think we'll maybe do a video for how to grade another time. Thank you.